Want to meet 5 amazing words and remember them for a lifetime? Well, you have reached the best destination on the internet to do so. This is Amit Kumar Mehta, and today I'll be trying to help you master 5 difficult words in an amazingly simple way so that you can remember them for a lifetime. These words will help you sound sophisticated in front of your friends, relatives, colleagues, and employer. Plus, these words will also help you score more in any competition exam which require English as a major component. So quickly moving on to the words, but before we do that, let me tell you, words number 2, 4 and 5 are my favorites, and very soon I'll try to ensure that these words become your favorites too, so that you can start using them immediately and you start sounding sophisticated and score more in competition exams. Moving on to the words. Word number 1 is unswerving. Unswerving basically means something that is not moving, something that is fixed, something that is unwavering, unshakable, firm, dedicated and committed. Committed to that particular cause. वो बिल्कुल भी move नहीं हो रहा है अपनी जगह से. That is अडिग है या अटल है. एक जगह पर fixed है, अपने thought process पे fixed है या अपने बातों पे fixed है. That is unswerving, not moving. Antonym would be somebody who is unreliable, half-hearted. Pronunciation is unswerving. Now, what is the way in which you can remember this word for a very, very long time? What is the wordaholic's way? What is the brain-friendly way to remember this word for a very, very long time? Look at the visual that we have provided. Something is un basically means if you add any word and before that you put an un, it basically means a negative connotation. Unswerving is unmoving. Swerving, आप imagine कीजिए कि something is moving and un अगर उसके पहले डाल दिया है, that means it is unswerving, that is something that is not moving. Look at the visual that we have provided and that will help you remember this word for a very, very long time. Unswerving means something that is not moving, something that is fixed. What are the various usages? Unswerving passion, उसके passion जो है fixed था. Unswerving devotion, people have devotion towards their roles. People have devotion towards their work. People have devotion towards their role models, actors. They have unswerving devotion towards their role model. Somebody is a die-hard fan. Unswerving devotion he has for a particular actor. That is unswerving. That is unmoving faith. Sentence 1. Huawei's unswerving input in R&D and innovation capabilities will enable it to become a top PC vendor globally. Huawei is investing a lot of money into R&D. Unswerving amount of money, fixed amount of money every year, unshakable, that is not moving, into R&D, and that will make it the number one company PC vendor globally. Sentence 2, the hiker has an unswerving resolve to scale peaks. Her determination is as tall as the Everest and as steadfast as K2. The hiker who is climbing the mountains has an unswerving resolve. दृढ़ निश्चय करके रखा हुआ है कि नहीं मुझे करना ही करना है. अनस्वर्विंग रिजॉल्व टू स्केल पीक्स टू क्लाइम माउंटेन्स दैट इज द हाइकर्स रिजॉल्व अनस्वर्विंग अनमूविंग. सेंटेंस 3 and 4 यू कैन डू ऑन योर ओन. मूविंग ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट वर्ड फॉर द डे विच आई टोल्ड यू इज माई फेवरेट अनटेनेबल. अनटेनेबल बेसिकली मीन समथिंग दैट इज अनसस्टेनेबल. Weak, something that is shaky, something that is baseless, something that is defective in nature, something that is moving, and asthir. Hindi would be asthir, jo hil raha hai, jo shaky hai, jiska foundation kamzor hai. Antonym is something which is sustainable. Pronunciation, untenable. Now, what is the brain-friendly way? The brain-friendly way to remember this word, look at the visual that we have provided. This is a boy who has become a boss. He's less than 10 years age. If he is less than 10 years age, in the word itself you have untenable. If you are under 10, you will definitely not be able to handle the responsibilities. You will be unsustainable as a boss. If you become a boss at age less than 10, you will become unsustainable as a boss. You will be weak and shaky in your arguments and people will not consider you as somebody with a strong base. It will be baseless, it will be defective in nature. So that is untenable. Below the age of 10, you are untenable. That is, you are not, your ideas are not sustainable. Sentences, look at the sentences, usages, untenable blind beliefs. Many people have beliefs which are untenable, which are not having a strong foundation of science. They are just religious beliefs and blind beliefs. They are not based on science. Untenable beliefs on which you cannot rely. Sentence 2, HC ban HC said ban was untenable. Ban was not required. Ban was unsustainable, is what High Courts had said. Sentence 1. Amir, continuing as the brand ambassador of Incredible India, was untenable after his speech on intolerance. When Amir Khan started speaking on intolerance, his Incredible India campaign, he became the wrong ambassador for that. His idea was against India, and that was he became an untenable ambassador, unsustainable. He could not sustain that particular position as the brand ambassador of India, as the brand ambassador of Incredible India. Sentence 2. The lawyers argued demanding 80% reservation for one group, which was not only wrong, it was untenable. Now, giving 80% reservation to one particular community is absolutely baseless, you would agree, and that is untenable. That is not possible, and that is untenable. Sentence 3 and 4, once again, you can do on your own by pausing the video. But before we move on to the next word, let me remind you that the link to all these 1200 words is available in the YouTube description of this video. Go to the YouTube description, download all those words, and start sounding sophisticated from today itself. Moving on to the next word for the day, up the ante. Up the ante is basically when you raise the quality of your argument, when you raise the quality of something, that is upping the ante. You are raising the bar, you are raising the quality of that particular thing. What are the various usages? Opponents up the ante. They have raised their fight, they have raised their arguments, they have raised their quality of arguments. BJP ups the ante on nationalism. BJP has raised the, suppose the volume on nationalism, suppose the quality on the debate on nationalism, BJP has raised that. Sentence 1. Honda ups the ante as customer demands more safety features in existing two-wheelers. Honda has upped the ante. They have increased the quality of their two-wheelers because customers today are demanding a lot of safety features in their two-wheelers. Sentence 2. Bar owners said they intend to up the ante in nightclub entertainment by introducing new extremely talented performers. Bar owners are upping the ante. They are increasing the quality of the performers that are performing in their bars. Why? Because the customers are probably asking for it. So that is upping the ante. You just raise the quality of some particular thing in your product offering. Sentence 3 and 4 you can do on your own once again by pausing the video. Moving on to the next word for the day, which I told you is again my favorite. Usurious. Now, what is the meaning of usurious? Usurious is basically something that is unreasonable, exorbitant, something that is outrageous, excessive. अत्याधिक आप उसको कह सकते हैं, अत्याधिक हो जाए, किसी चीज़ की अति हो जाए, that is usurious. Antonym is moderate. आपने खाने में ज़्यादा नमक डाल दिया, that is usurious. आपने नॉर्मल नमक डाला, that is moderate. So that is kind of an understanding you can have about the word usurious. Pronunciation, usurious, that is how you pronounce this word. Now, what is the brain-friendly way, you would ask? What is the brain-friendly way to remember this word for a very, very long time? What is the wordaholic's way to remember this word for a very, very long time? Look at the visual that we have provided. Imagine this particular person is the Asur. Asur in Hindi means somebody who is a demon, somebody who is the Rakshas. Imagine the moneylenders of the villages. Moneylenders of the villages, they are kind of the demons of the market. They charge exorbitantly. They charge unreasonable amount of interest. Sometimes they charge 100% interest. Jitna aapne principal liya hai, utna hi aapko interest bhi chukana padega. That is an usurious demand. That is an exorbitant demand. Unreasonable demand hai wo. That is usurious. What are the various usages? Usurious moneylenders. यूसूरियस को जब भी देखेंगे तो इमेजिन कीजिए कि असुर हैं मनी लेंडर्स, जो मनी विलेजेस में देते हैं. यूसूरियस मनी लेंडर्स, यूसूरियस मिडिलमैन. इवन समटाइम्स द मिडिलमैन आल्सो टेक अ लॉट ऑफ प्रॉफिट्स ऑफ द पुअर फार्मर्स एंड ऑफ द पुअर रिटेलर्स एंड वेंडर्स. दे किल द एंटायर कॉम्पिटिशन. दे टेक अ वेरी हेफ्टी कमीशन एंड दे किल द पर्सन हु इज डूइंग द बिजनेस, द पुअर पर्सन हु इज डूइंग द बिजनेस, बिकॉज ऑफ देयर यूसूरियस पॉलिसीज. They are usurious middlemen. Sentence 1. Local politicians are inciting violence at toll plazas from time to time, demanding reduction in usurious toll collection. Now, toll most of the Indians do not want to pay. At the toll plazas, they do not want to pay the toll. Most of the locals say that these are usurious tolls, usurious taxes. These should not be realized. These are unreasonable tolls. Why should we be paying taxes for driving on our own roads? We are living in a free country. Why should we be paying taxes? That is an usurious, unreasonable tax. That is an exorbitant tax. Too much money is being demanded. That is usurious in nature. Sentence 2, citing usurious loans as a major research reason for farmer suicides, RBI should take strict action against private money lenders. Now, many of the farmers are committing suicides. Why? Because of the usurious loans. Because the farmers are not able to pay those usurious, unreasonable loan amounts, they are committing suicide. And RBI should intervene is what the sentence is trying to say. Moving on to the last word for the day, once again, my favorite, utopian. Utopian basically means something that is idealistic, something that is paradisical, something that is blissful, heavenly, divine, जिसकी आप सपने में कामना करते हो, काल्पनिक जो हो, जो आदर्श लोक हो, आपके लिए जो एक सपना है, that is utopian world for you, कि ऐसा हो जाता तो कितना अच्छा हो जाता, that is utopian world for you. Antonym is something that is down to earth, that is something basis moderate or normal. And utopian is something that is paradisical. आप heaven में पहुंच जाते हो तो heaven कैसा होगा आपकी imagination के हिसाब से, that is utopian. Sentence, what is the way in which you can remember this particular word? Look at the visual that we have provided. Imagine the topi which you get from the on winning a particular contest. Imagine the topi that this takdeer ki topi जो DID winners को दी जाती है. जो डी आई डी एक शो था, डांस का शो था, उसमें द विनर गेट्स अ यूटोपी, अ टोपी, एंड दैट टोपी सिग्निफाइज दैट यू हैव वन समथिंग, यू आर नो एवरीबडी इज सेलिब्रेटिंग एंड यू फील दैट इट इज पैराडाइज, यू हैव रीच्ड हेवन, ऑलमोस्ट यू हैव रीच्ड हेवन वंस यू हैव वन दैट पर्टिकुलर टोपी. So that is how you remember this particular word. Usages, utopian expectations. My expectations were utopian, were paradisical, were heavenly. My bosses were having utopian expectations from me. बहुत ज़्यादा expectations मेरे से कर रहे थे क्योंकि normal नहीं था वो, बहुत ज़्यादा था. Utopian idea, the idea is utopian. ये idea possible नहीं है, ऐसा सिर्फ heaven में हो सकता है, that is a utopian idea. वो normal ground में नहीं हो सकता है, वो normal देश में नहीं हो सकता, भारत में नहीं हो सकता, that is a utopian idea. Sentence 1, the idea of a utopian world gets around without the need for fossil fuel is a utopian dream for the moment. द आइडिया कि फॉसिल फ्यूअल आएगा और पेट्रोल और डीजल की कमी हो जाएगी, पेट्रोल और डीजल की ज़रूरत नहीं रहेगी, इज़ अ यूटोपियन आइडिया कि हम लोग घास फूस से हम लोग बिजली पैदा कर पाएंगे और पेट्रोल की गाड़ियाँ और गाड़ियाँ चला पाएंगे, दैट इज़ अ यूटोपियन आइडिया, दैट इज़ नॉन पॉसिबल, दैट इज़ नॉट पॉसिबल, दैट इज़ अ हेवनली आइडिया, इट डज़ नॉट साउंड रियल. Sentence 1 was done. Sentence 2, smart city is a utopian concept. कि smart city होंगे, सब चीज़ें connect होंगी एक दूसरे के साथ में, mode of transport अच्छा होगा, that is a utopian concept. वो real नहीं लगता सुनने में, that is a utopian heavenly kind of a concept. That is a divine concept, क्योंकि which is not real in nature. So sentence 3 and 4, once again you can do on your own by pausing the video. And with that particular word, we have reached the end of the presentation for today. It was a long presentation, but still these are words which I think if you can start using from today onwards in your vocabulary, you will start sounding sophisticated, you will start sounding intelligent, you will start sounding as if you are well read, well educated, and these words will help you score more in examinations. So if you have not liked and subscribed our page, please do like and subscribe. And as usual, as I keep on telling you, go to the playlist section. The playlist section in today's date contains more than 350 words, all there for you, so that you can start sounding sophisticated and score more. And if you have not shared this video, please share. I want more and more likes. I want to reach as many students across India as much as possible. So your shares will help me reach as many students as possible. Thank you so much. It was a pleasure interacting with you. See you tomorrow with a new word. Thank you so much.